If you knew you were about to die, what would you want your loved ones to know? What would you want to tell the people who you love the most? Moses was about to die, and he asked himself the same question. What do I want the children of Israel to know? And so that's actually what the book of Deuteronomy is about. Moses is about to die, and he finally does this long speech, this long sermon to the people who he's cared for and helped and ministered for 40 plus years. And he has some really important things to say. You might want to say, well, I want to tell them to take care of their loved ones. I want to tell the people who I love most, all these different things. But Moses takes a different route. And I want to share a little bit what Moses talks about in the book of Deuteronomy. Moses gathers the people together, and he begins to talk to them about something really important. It's called the Shema, and it's found in Deuteronomy chapter 6. And the Shema says this: "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might." Moses knew the Israelites pretty well. He was their pastor and their leader for over 40 years. And he knew that their biggest struggle wasn't the food they ate or their attendance, but it was that they had a problem that with loving others and loving themselves. And so this is why he gives them this command to love the Lord with all of your heart, with all of your soul, and with all of your might. And so I want to just dive a little bit into what does it mean to love God with all of my heart? What does it mean to love God with all of my soul and with all of my strength and all of my might? Because it might seem obvious, but these things are actually a little bit difficult to understand sometimes. Love the Lord with all of your heart. What does that mean? Our heart is where we dream and we plan and we get excited about things. When we're excited about a new job, or when we're excited about a new baby that's come into our life, that's where our heart blooms. And so when it says, love the Lord with all of your heart, love the Lord with all of your plans, with all of your desires, with all of your aspirations, and make sure that every part of who you are, of all of your heart, is devoted to God. While your heart might be your plans and your dreams and the things that you want to accomplish, your soul is the essence of who you are. In the book of Genesis, we find out that a soul is the breath of God combined with the human body, and that becomes a living soul, a living person, a living being. And so to love God with all of your soul then would be love God with your whole personality of who you are. When people talk to you and you have interactions with people at the gas station, at the bus stop, at your home, or in different places around town, does the conversation of God ever pop up with who you are? When you're in an interview and they say, tell me a little bit about yourself, does God pop up? Or is it just, I'm an architect, or I work here, and I work in the oil field? Is it, what is the essence of who you are? Is God a part of that? Or do you have to only go to church and then God is a part of who you are? And so when Moses says, love the Lord with all of your soul, this is who you are. Love him with every part of who you are. The last part of the Shema, Moses tells the people to love the Lord with all of your might, all of your strength. This last year, I had COVID in March and April, and something I noticed that happened really quickly is that after I had slowly recovered, I started to lose a lot of strength and energy. I couldn't do anything. In fact, I was washing the dishes for about 30 minutes one day. I wanted to get things done. I wanted to be helpful in the home, and I just couldn't do it. I finished the dishes and I had to rest and sleep for the rest of the day. It was embarrassing and it was terrible, but that's just the effect that COVID had on my body. My body just wasn't recovering very, very quickly. When the Bible says to love God with all of your strength, it means with all of your might, with all of your energy. And that means to put all of your focus, all of your willpower, all of your strength towards the mission that God has given you. And so if God has given you the mission of the homeless, to feed the homeless and to take care of the homeless, then that would mean that you would put all of your energies, all of your strength, all of your planning, everything to accomplish this mission. If God has called you to Work with widows. The same thing. Whatever God has called you to do, love the Lord with all of your energy, with all of your strength. Put all of your effort into that one area. As Moses is coming to the end of the sermon, this of the book of Deuteronomy, he comes to these two mountains and he's about to give them continue his sermon on curses and blessings. And he says that if you will worship and obey God, you'll receive all of these blessings that will go onward to many, many generations. Your children, your great-grandchildren, your great-great-great-grandchildren will receive these wonderful, wonderful blessings in the promised land. But if you disobey him and you are disobedient to his word and to his commands that he has given in the Torah, then you're going to receive cursings. But Moses knows the people very well, and in fact, he knows something about them that is true about you and me, and that is that we have a really hard time obeying and following directions, and so he knows that they're going to fail, but he knows that something has to happen in order for them to succeed, and the people can't do it, they can't accomplish it, there's not some memory verse they can memorize, there's not some doctrine that they can implement amongst their worship services that'll help them receive these blessings and not these cursings. There's one thing that has to happen, it can only happen from God, and it's quite strange. In Deuteronomy chapter 30 and verse 6, it says this, "And the Lord your God will circumcise your hearts and the hearts of your offsprings." What does that even mean? That seems so strange and so crude. What does it mean that God is going to circumcise our hearts? Well, Moses knew, and so did God, that the children of Israel were very disobedient, as we said before. But something needed to change. It wasn't that their actions were bad or they didn't know how to love others or how to love God. There was a sin component that was engraved into their heart. And so God needed to circumcise that off of their hearts to remove that completely. And if that was removed, like it had been removed of Moses, how his issue of anger had been removed as God was working with him, Moses knew that God would continue the work of his people and he would be able to mold and frame their heart in such a way that they would have a desire to love God instead of a desire to do all these other things. And so God knew that there has to be an internal transformation that had to happen. And maybe you're watching this, I need that same internal transformation, but I don't know how to do it. I don't know how it can be accomplished. Well, there's good news. And that is that God wants to transform your heart internally. And so if you want to receive an internal transformation so that you too can love the Lord your God with all of your heart, with all of your soul, and with all of your strength, then I encourage you to pray a prayer and pray, Lord, I desire to be changed and transformed internally. And so I want to invite you into my heart to continue to do that work. I give you permission to have your Holy Spirit to mend and mold my heart so that it may be just as beautiful as yours. Amen. I hope that you have enjoyed this time together. I've enjoyed spending this time with you, and I hope you'll stay tuned for our other devotionals coming your way. Have a wonderful day, and God bless you.